JonBenet Ramsey's death remains one of the nation's most high-profile unsolved murder cases. Today, she would be 21. Her father, John Ramsey, is still waiting for her killer to be found.
It was a horrific crime. The murder of a child is just beyond any normal person's comprehension.
In the 15 years since JonBenet's brutal murder, one media expert noted that the still unsolved slaying of the elfin beauty queen initiated one of the foulest, yellowest chapters in contemporary U.S. journalism.
You were pilloried.
Yeah.
By the press, yeah. By the authorities,
yeah.
By the world.
The police always look at the parents first. We learned that, and we accepted that, and just assumed they would complete that cycle and then move on, which, of course, they did not. But, you know, it didn't matter, really. But what mattered was we lost our child, and that was the crushing blow. And the rest of it was, like, whatever. You know, we just accepted it. Mm-hmm. We would have given everything to have our child back.
JonBenet's murder was not the only tragedy her father, John Ramsey, suffered. Over the span of the last 14 years, he lost his oldest daughter, Beth, who was killed in a car accident. Little JonBenet, and then his wife Patsy, just 49, to cancer. Patsy never lived to see their family publicly exonerated as suspects in JonBenet's slaying.
How long did you have to live with this, as the term was coined at the time, the umbrella of suspicion?
We were officially cleared and apologized to by the district attorney in 2008. So that was 12 years.
Mary Lacey, then Boulder's district attorney, made a public announcement that new DNA evidence cleared the Ramsey family as suspects in the case. The letter read in part, "This DNA profile belongs to the perpetrator of the homicide. The suspicions about the Ramseys in this case created an ongoing living hell for the Ramsey family and their friends, which added to their suffering. We believe that justice dictates that the Ramseys be treated only as victims of this serious crime."
I didn't view it as a, you know, let's go out and celebrate. It was just another step in the right direction. But the interesting thing was that, you know, of course, the media was out to lynch us, and individual people were wonderful to us. It really opened my eyes to how compassionate people can be and how important that is. We certainly saw evidence and examples of how God takes things and turns them for good. I got a letter from a lady several years ago that said I was contemplating suicide, and I decided if you could handle your problems, I could certainly handle mine.
In time, John's grief gave way to happy memories of his daughter.
I still, of course, think of JonBenet as a sweet little six-year-old.
John, a New York Times best-selling author, has written a book, The Other Side of Suffering, to encourage people broken by tragedy or injustice. He says the death of his oldest daughter, Beth, in 1992 was the beginning of his faith journey.
First words out of my mouth as I hung up the phone that morning were, "There is no God." You know, I just screamed that, "There is no God." Because it just didn't make sense.
Car accident,
middle of the day, just a freak accident. She and her boyfriend were both killed. I really hit rock bottom, and I was, prior to that time, was a cultural Christian. I just was a Christian because I was born in a Christian home, and that's what you did on Sundays, and I didn't really get it, didn't really understand it. Some good friends came alongside me, one in particular took me aside and said, "John, I've been praying for you. I want to spend time with you." Taught me how to study the Bible, my faith had really grown.
What do you understand now about God and Jesus that you didn't know back then?
Jesus is real. He's who he said he was. I firmly believe that. I can communicate with him through prayer. He's in our life. He's real. So when JonBenet was murdered, I had faith. It wasn't just a logical exercise. It had gone from my head to my heart. So I knew JonBenet was okay and with God, and I didn't question God, you know, as to why did this happen.
John's suffering continued. Patsy had been healed of stage 4 ovarian cancer in 1994, but 8 years later, it was back.
2002, Patsy's cancer returns.
She had, I think, 3 remissions over the next 3 or 4 years. And then the point came where I just wanted God to take her home because she was suffering so much. I was like, God, just please take her home. It's time. It's time to end this suffering and struggle. Death became both a sorrow and a relief for me in a strange way. I mean, we knew we'd miss her terribly, but I was grateful that she was not suffering anymore.
As a widower and single father, John was challenged by a friend to live as if his best days were ahead. He spent time in India serving local pastors.
You joined up with YWAM, Youth mm-hmm. with a Mission, mm-hmm. to become a missionary to India.
It was a wonderful experience and really moved my spiritual journey along double time.
He also fell in love with and married Jan.
Jan, my wife, grew up in Ethiopia as a missionary kid and real solid believer, so we've had a wonderful marriage and been a blessing for me and helped me develop this view that the best days of my life were still ahead of me.
Through all of this, John, you could have come out on the other side of it, an angry, bitter, resentful man. You didn't.
Mm-hmm. No. And I think there were several factors. One is we were really blessed by the compassion of our fellow man. People just reached out to us and carried our spirits and encouraged us and apologized for what was being said and done to us. And it really was an uplifting experience for us.
Through all this process, suffering is part of the package mm-hmm. that Jesus says you inherit when you embrace him.
Gonna happen.
Yeah.
I've learned that pretty much everybody suffers at some point in their life. Life's not necessarily easy. No. And people struggle, and particularly nowadays. And that was a kind of an eye opener for me. And that it has a beginning and an end. And that's kind of what the book was to encourage people about, that there is an end to suffering. It's not forever.